Long, long ago, in our very own town of India, there were six blind men. They all lived together. The life was very difficult. But the people of their town came and helped them with whatever they needed. People would even read them stories to make them understand what the outside world was. But there was one question which always remained in them. They did not understand what an elephant is. They had even heard stories of Lord Ganesha and stories of other elephants. One of them said, "I really want to find out what an elephant is." The other said, "Well, I have heard that in the Raja's palace garden, there lived many elephants. Maybe if we can go there tomorrow, we can find out what an elephant is." So the next morning, after breakfast, each one of the blind men lined up with the hand on the shoulder of the one in the front, and the shortest man took his long white cane, and they walked along tapping and calling for directions. "Which way? Which way do we go to the Raja's palace? Somebody please help us. Which way?" There was no safe place for them to walk. But there was a young boy who helped them manage to turn this way and that way and right and left and that way and this until they arrived at the Raja's palace gates. When they reached the gates, to their delight, the soldier keeping the gates was someone whom they knew. He gladly agreed to their request and said,
"Please wait here and I'll see what I can do."
The soldier went to the Raja himself and explained. The kind Raja ordered that his largest elephant brought into the courtyard. The soldier came back and said,
"Follow me and you will find out what an elephant is."
The blind man followed the soldier until he said,
"Now you all are standing directly in front of the elephant."
Those six blind men spread out in a line and they put out their hands in front of them and walked forward slowly. The first one to touch the elephant felt something that was rough and big and huge.
"Wow! Why this elephant feels like a wall?"
He was excited. "An elephant is like a wall?" he thought to himself. He had touched the side of an elephant. The next blind man was the shortest. When he reached out his hands, he felt something round, cylindrical, and went all the way till the ground. He said, "Wow! I couldn't have guessed the elephant is like a tree." He had touched the elephant's leg. Now, the one in the end of the elephant felt something thin, round, hairy and hanging down. "Uh-oh! This elephant just feels like a rope." "An elephant is like a rope?" He was disappointed. He had touched the elephant's tail. On the other end of the elephant, one of the men touched something that was thin and flat.
"Oh my God! An elephant is flat like a fan?"
"It is just like a fan." He had touched the elephant's ears. Next man touched something that was hard, smooth and curved down. And when he was at the end, ouch! Ah! Ah! It
snake poked his hand. He thought he had hit the spear. An elephant is like a spear. He had touched the tusk of the elephant. The last one reached out his two hands, and when he touched, it was something that wiggled and moved and writhed.
Oh gosh! It's just like a snake! I have to let it go before it bites me!
He thought, and he just let it go. He was scared. He had touched the trunk of the elephant. After a few minutes, the blind man, one after the other, said, "The elephant is like a fan."
"A fan? No. It is like a snake. I had to let it go before it bit me."
"No, an elephant is like a spear." "Oh, you were all crazy."
No. It is just like a rope. Somebody has tricked us."
The other disagreed and said, "It is like a tree." And the other said,
No. It's like an enormous wall."
They all began to shout at each other in louder and louder voices until the Raja of the palace could hear. He came down to the courtyard and listened for a minute and then said,
"Stop! You are all arguing because all six are right and all six are wrong. An elephant is an enormous, immense animal. Each of you have found out just one part of the elephant. If you want to understand what an elephant is, you must talk together, listen and share. Understand how all those pieces fit together to be one big animal." These men sat down silently on the grass. After a while, they began to speak again. They listened to one another while they understood what an elephant is. Now they all lined up again, each with their hand on the shoulder of the one in the front. And they went home the way they had come, calling out for directions, happy because now they had learned from one another what an elephant really is. Now that's the story of six blind men and the elephant. Thank you.